real gift of Christmas. The gift. Love so great from God that through His Son, you and I can live forever. I think it's no coincidence that sometimes in our conversations, you know, those one-on-ones that we have with Jesus, if you're occasionally in doubt or you're confused and you say to Him, Lord, how much more do you expect me to take on these shoulders? How much more can I handle? I don't know, quite frankly, how much you love me. And by the way, how much do you love me? And Jesus says, I don't love you this much, or this much, or this much. I have always loved you this much to die on a cross for you. That's how much I love you. He shows you every time you ask. Jesus says, child of mine, look at me. I love you this much. Recognize the gift you've just received this Christmas. It's a gift of all eternity. Think about it, life everlasting, and it came as a gift. You can't purchase it. You won't find it on QVC. It isn't in Best Buy or Sam's Club. Eternal life is offered to each of us freely as a gift from the author and creator of the universe. Same creator who can do square stems on little flowers. And think of the way the gift was delivered. Not through FedEx or, UPS. It was delivered by a young girl in the first century Israel and announced by a host of heavenly beings, singing, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Can't we use that right now on this dusty, troubled, old planet? Some peace for people of goodwill. Gifts have wrappings too, but this gift didn't have the wrappings of a box from Tiffany's or something from Macy's. This gift was wrapped in swaddling clothes, the garment of a newborn in the Middle East 2,000 years ago. And instead of a bright box from Tiffany's, his arrival carton was a manger, a feed box for cows and oxen. And for perhaps most of his life, just his mother and father, the shepherds and wise men, and later, his 12 disciples were the only ones who really and truly first appreciated the gift. Then humanity started to hear about him. And from the first century to today, our gift is to be shared with others. It's for us to pass on and pass down the wonderful news of the angels about the gift for all humanity. Look around in your dome church. How are each of us here spreading the news of the gift? Indeed, you might even ask, are we truly spreading the news of the gift? Never forget about 12 years ago, hearing on a news program that England had entered a post-Christian era. Stopping in my tracks. What? Christianity has eclipsed and gone down the other side in England? Yes, it has. Sadly, what becomes sadder is that the United States is approaching its eclipse with Christianity. You know, we are approaching that. In the year that's about to happen, in 2016, the Northeast jurisdiction of the United Methodist Church can lose one, perhaps even a second, annual conference because the membership declines. That's frightening. But the good news is we can change that. We're approaching it, but we can change it. An old axiom in the public relations field is the saying, if it's going to be, it's up to me. Think about that. If it's going to be, it's up to me. And that means if something's going to happen, I'm the person who's going to make it happen. You and I are the hands and feet of God the Father in spreading the tidings of great joy about this gift of eternal life. Are we doing that? Think back to the people in the church I grew up in. The Ladies Aid Society in that church baked cookies to take to Luzerne County Juvenile Detention Center at Christmas time. Every year from the return to school in September, will tell you that $3,000 becomes really significant when you realize that those women raised that money, that $3,000, selling those individual pasties at 50 cents a piece. Wow. I remember working weekends in April and springtime at our church camp, renting the property for another season of campers. Men of the church would work tirelessly throughout Friday evening, all day Saturday, and finish with worship on Sunday morning, just so that young people could come face to face with Jesus Christ in a summer camp experience. Many for the first time. Lives were formed and changed there, mine included. Each one of those women, those men, those youth were doing what your mission statement says in today's bulletin, making disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. They were spreading that good news that first happened on the hillside, sharing the gift with all around them. How are we doing today? Are we following in the footsteps of our forebears? You have your own great history here of people who spread those glad tidings here in Mountaintop. And now we have to be the torchbearers to keep the word alive and passing the gift on. I started with two dangers a couple of minutes ago. The first being, why are we here? And are we doing what we can to proclaim the greatest gift in human history? I don't know about you, but the two worst questions I can think of hearing at the pearly gates are, Bill, what were you there for? And what did you do to tell others about that gift of eternal life I gave?